Bills fans coming with snaps on the down line. Dan McClung with that one-of-a-kind dive play. In 1980, Christian Industries was busy
on board of Mr. Don Lee, came a double sweat wing dive play.
We wound up with a project in Can you say eye-popping, spectacular, out-of-the-box performance? The Talon Eagle represents innovative and technological advances over any other biplane in the past. He performed 400 carrier landings in the A-7 Corsair and the A-4 Skyhawk. He was running a major air carrier as a pilot. And currently lives right here.
That's just the pre-centerpiece.
Wait till he pulls the nose up. He'll pull up on a ballistic arc all the way down the stage. Here he goes. He's got the nose up. He's pulling it around into the snap rolls right here. Sinking down into his seat with 6 times the force of gravity on these snap rolls. Mr. Dan McClung with the Talon Eagle from Red Eagle Air Sport.
To have a lot of fun with Danny flying the air show down in Peachtree City, and every season he'd fly there, he would try to break the unofficial inverted flat spin record. I think we got him up to 23 turns one year before he finally lost his nerve and kicked.
Tent set up along the back of the show line here today. Stop by and pay him a visit, learn a little more about the products. They're one of the world's leading aerospace coatings and sealant companies. As you see the Talon backing back down through the smoke, you see that beautiful red, white, and black paint job. That's PPG Aviation Coatings. It's PPG Aerospace's
plane. Hanging on that 375 horsepower engine. Whoa, here is Buck Hoffman with the Red Eagle. Crossing, diving back in. Ladies and gentlemen, Dan McClung and Buck Hoffman.
To fuel and clean airplanes in exchange for flying time. Working with airplanes was just the start for Eric. He had his eyes on the stars and later went to work for the NASA space program on space shuttles and Titan rockets. And there's that hover I promised. He's holding it up. He's holding it up. He's coming around. He's holding that. He's holding that. How long has he got to hold that? Going round and round. That was more than 360 to me. Beautiful. Start to back up.
The broken fire out in front, but there goes that jet fire. Look out, air's upside down.
Dedication over the last Snodgrass flying the F-86. Once joined, they will return to Show Center for the United States Air Force Heritage Flight. We hope you enjoy watching this rare formation flight of...
Aircraft. You've never seen anything quite like what you're about to see.
Okay, they're rolled back up right. They're about to cross over and make for some spacing. And here comes the cross, ladies and gentlemen. Dan McClung and Matt Rosen. They'll be setting up for the formation barrel roll. Stagger all the way down the show line here as they combine the loop and the roll to spiral across the sky.
Aerobatic team. In fact, these airplanes both had Frank Christensen's hands on them at one time.
As they come over the top, they're actually floating at nearly zero G. They feel like an astronaut in orbit at the top. And as they're coming back down, they're sinking back down to four and a half, five times the force of gravity of the bottom half of that to be demonstrated by the Blues later on today. They've got six airplanes to do this. They go all over the sky. We've got two airplanes. We're going to use this maneuver to split off our two airplanes and set up for some individual spins of the box as they split off. And there you have the rolling past, Dan. Taking it to the vertical, Mr. Buck Roman with that Red Eagle. Now, this aircraft is a highly modified version of the Christian Eagle 2 kit that's commercially available. You see he's got it hanging up, coming back down the tail slide with the wheels to the crowd, pushes it over for the recovery, and he'll be doing an outside push back to level flight. Now, those outside pushes, they take up to keep track of the horizon. They'll be looking out on top of the canopy to keep track of each other. Let's listen in with Dan McClung and Buck Roman for the Squirrel Cage Loops.
Thank you.
precision level. She's getting negative and positive G's on this one now, making it very, very tough to compare some precision. The smoke doesn't mind. Patty, Wagstaff's videos are fun to watch, particularly the ones with the camera on in the cockpit. Back before she cut her hair, you should have seen what it did at plus and minus 9 G's.
Information on Sean, our show schedule, we got photographs, and our latest addition is an animated game called Operation Software Drop. And now at Show Center, in a virtual hover, it's called the Harrier Pass, named in honor of the United States Marine Corps, AV-8B Harrier. Ladies and gentlemen of Atlanta... Rolls the formation 180 degrees to the upright position. Completing the half Cuban 8 on takeoff, the Diamond will pass before us and exit the flight line to the left. Back to the right. Blue Angels 5 and 6 are rolling. Major Anderson will perform the dirty roll on takeoff, while Lieutenant Olsen executes a very precise low transition. Once again, this time to demonstrate the inverted flight capabilities of these F-18s.
The Angels over Atlanta Air Show wrapped up today in Cobb County. The two-day event caused traffic gridlock in the area around Dobbins Air Reserve Base. Now, organizers expected 100,000 people to come out over the two-day period, but they believe that more than that number showed up on Saturday alone. Well, of course, the main attraction at the show, the Navy's Blue Angels.
Yeah, Fox 5's Russ Spencer had a very rare opportunity to fly in the back seat of one of those fighter jets, and he joins us now with a first-hand look at what it's like, and all I can say, Russ, is, wow. I'm impressed.
That's how I felt, too. Lisa Corey, it was the thrill of a lifetime. The Blue Angels are impressive enough from the ground. At times, they fly within 18 inches of each other at 700 miles an hour. Now, what you can't see and what I felt on a 40-minute ride in the FA-18 Hornet this week is the tremendous G-forces they withstand to make that aerial ballet look so easy.
Blue 8-7 has cleared round robin at Dobbins.
Ready to go?
I am ready to go.
On a crystal clear afternoon this week, Blue Angel Lieutenant Justin Otto, number 7, took me on the ultimate joyride.
Like a rocket. Pulled you right out of the seat. Wow.
And gave me yet another reason to appreciate the men and the machines that protect our freedom.
So that was 6.7 Gs, is that right?
It sure was.
We jetted toward the Alabama border at close to the speed of sound, where number 7 found some open space to spread his wings and to humble his passenger.
There's about 4 Gs right there. Now put your head back.
I am. With no invitation. Well, that is something else. That is incredible. You guys get paid to do this, right?
I wouldn't trade it for the world.
That's the attitude and the pride that characterized the entire Blue Angels team of 125 officers and enlisted personnel, whose primary mission is to inspire the next generation of young Navy and Marine flyers.
You're going to have straps right here across your legs. You're going to slide your hand underneath that.
Now, I may be too old to join up, but before the flight...
You're going to flex your leg muscles as you're pushing yourself up. Curl your toes towards the floor.
Crew Chief Chris Fancher patiently prepared me for the G-forces and the worst-case scenarios.
You're going to hear him say, eject, eject, eject. There's two enlisted jobs in the Navy that fly in the back of fighter jets. That's mine and the other guy that does my job. So... Very lucky, very fortunate. This would be the boss bag, right?
All right, we'll make it work.
So, picking up where we left off, I was feeling pretty good.
Here's a little zero G. That's pretty fun.
I'll bet that farmer's never seen his place like that before.
And this is what it sounds like in the cockpit when they fly in formation.
He says we're in a right turn, the diamond roll. A little pull. Okay, now look out at the wingtips. Imagine those guys hanging on out there.
I can't. So now, here we are completely upside down.
As it turned out, number 7 was just getting warmed up.
Here's a little negative G.
My head's on the canopy. Is that normal?
Yeah.
Little pull. Oh, it's going dark.
Wow. All right. Nice job. So that was 7.1. Or 7.3.
Yeah.
That, roll to the right. Wow.
Nice job. I came close to passing out, and not for the last time. Lieutenant Otto, who has landed on an aircraft carrier 276 times, got me to cry uncle on the carrier brake they used to slow down for landing.
That's enough.
Enough almost to join the long list of media types who have lost their lunch in number 7.
Empty barf bag.
But not today.
Wow.
Thank
you very much.
Yeah.
You get a sense that there are kids who specifically been inspired to join the Navy?
Absolutely. I was one of them. You know, first time I saw the Blue Angels, I was about 6 years old, and I still remember that.
Lieutenant Otto has flown missions in the Persian Gulf and the Mediterranean, and when his 3 years with the Blue Angels are over, he will go back to the fleet.
Is there any special significance to you doing this now that the country is at war?
Well, I mean, I think it just means a lot to us just to be able to represent, you know, everyone that's over there fighting the war right now. Many of them are our friends.
Now, when it was over, I felt like I'd run a few miles, and Lieutenant Otto looked as though he'd just taken a refreshing nap. The Blue Angels are, of course, among the best pilots in the fleet, but I'm told that one of the most important things the Navy looks for in the interview process of pilot candidates is attitude, the kind of guy who will talk with fans at the flight line and inspire a child to say, you know what, I want to be like him.
I want to be like him.
I want to be like
so
him.
Cool.
Yeah.
To tell the truth, you really didn't get sick.
I did not get sick, but I can still taste it 5 days later. And I really almost passed out several times. They say it's like those old picture tubes. Remember how it would turn off this
right.
way?
Right.
Just got
right.
dark and dark
right.
and dark, and then he'd let me. They say that every once in a while people really do pass out. Wake up a few seconds later. Don't worry, it won't kill
imagine.
You.
I got a little nauseous just watching the story. There,
Well, it really was a thrill of a lifetime, and I appreciate it
very
much.
Good. All right,
Russ.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Russ.